This week, we're fishing the Sacramento River for winter run king salmon. And then we're on Northern California's Lake Berryessa with Rick Kennedy for a red hot spoon bite for rainbow trout. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Been a good year for the fall run of salmon on the Sacramento River, but now it's time for the winter run to start trickling in, which gives anglers an opportunity to hook into big, hard-fighting salmon if they're willing to put in the time and effort to catch these prized fish. Today, the recipient of the Wear It California campaign Day of Fishing with Angler West TV, Mike Riley, is fishing with guide Raith Heryford and Don Newman of P-Line, and Mike was able to bring his friend Daryl Watts as part of this fishing tutorial with Angler West Television. Today, Raith Heryford is giving a lesson on catching fast-moving, unpredictable winter-run salmon.
Yeah, yesterday we came in here and there was a big pile of fish right here. Well, anyways, we got a double hookup right here and we're using a jig, a P-Line laser minnow. And we're dropping them down with a single hook. And you got to watch the hook because, as you can see here, if you just fling them up in the air and you let them fall, the hook will fold up alongside the lure like that, and then when your fish bites it, you won't have a hook to set the hook. So what you do is you flip it up in the air and you follow it down kind of tight. You want to stop it, and then let it hit the bottom, and that way the hook will be down here. And so basically you're following your lure up and down. You're trying to keep your hook like that with still keeping action. You got to let your lure follow for the actions. Before we put the jigs down, we're going to try trolling upstream with a Brad's killer lure. And we're gonna troll real slow up through them, and then we'll vertical jig back through them. So that way we can do two things in one hole. So we give the fish a chance to, if they like these, when we come through this morning, we're gonna troll real slow upstream with a heavy weight. You can use 2, 3, 4 ounces. If it only takes an ounce to get down, it doesn't matter because it's 20 feet deep. We want the guys in the front and the guys in the back to be spread out. So we're gonna run a little heavier weight on the lures in the front than the back. And we're gonna run a big lure. It's the 16, and with the sardine wrapper, and so we'll start off doing this, and then we'll vertical jig on our way back.
I've never used a flatfish with a weight.
Yeah, what you're gonna do is you just let your line out. You'll feel it hit the bottom. Once it hits the bottom, you click it over, and we'll go a little bit, maybe 10 yards forward. Let a little more line out. Make sure you're on the bottom because we're gonna troll forward. You feel it hit. You'll feel it thump. Okay, yeah. Then click it over. And just every once in a while lift up on it and then ease it back down. There you go, just like that, perfect. Because you don't want to get too far back, because if he bites it up here, you'll have no room to set the hook. So it's just right here. What you're going to do, it'll charge that lure. As you lift your rod up and you go to set it back, it's going to charge up the lure, make it wobble a little erratic, and then the fish will come up and you'll create your strike.
And Raith, does that have the new UV finish? I know they're building some with UV finishes now.
Yeah, I don't know if that's it or not. It's like a flash tape looking stuff on the back, but it's a good looking lure, and it's working, homie. So we'll just keep using them. As long as they work, we'll use whatever works. So yeah, it's a great lure.
As part of the Wear It California campaign, we were given these carbon light rod and reel combos from Bass Pro Shops. Can't get over how much feeling they have in them. Very, very light. And you can really feel the weights and everything bouncing off the bottom as we're fishing for these salmon.
Okay, everybody reel in, and we're going to switch over to the spoon. We come to the top of the hole, and when it comes up, then we're going to work back down the drop off, and we'll work the spoons back. So we didn't get any strikes. We didn't see any fish roll or anything, but we'll put the spoons on now, and that way I can work in and out of the snags, get a little tighter to the banks and to the bridge pilings and that, and we'll see if we can't pick up a fish that way.
That reminds me of bass fishing, dropping spoons down real deep at the lakes and stuff like this. This is going to be a blast right here. We hook one of these big ones up.
Okay, as Raith mentioned earlier, the regulation on the river is that you've got to have a single hook on anything over 1 ounce. The laser minnow comes with a treble hook on it, and Raith basically just takes the split ring off, takes the standard treble hook that it comes with, and he switches it out to a single sidewash.
Yeah.
Now, we make 18 different colors in this, but I know you have some certain colors that you like that have been doing extremely well with.
Definitely, definitely. This green, blue, and silver right here, it's been the hot ticket for everything. The stripers and the salmon both have seemed to like it a lot. And as you can see, I've taken the ring off. This is a Gamagatsu sidewash hook. It's open right here. You just put it on like that. It's real simple. You know, you buy them from anywhere, and you put it on like that. You take a pair of pliers and you just crimp it down. Boom, you're done. It's that fast, and you know, you're fishing right there. So, and you know, like we said earlier, this single hook, it works well. I mean, you're not gonna foul hook any salmon. There's a big problem with salmon. They get in these holes, they're tired, they're just laying down there. And if you give them a chance to bite, they will bite. But if you drop down there with the treble hook and you start ripping it through there, because you have to rip your lure up to get the action on the fall. So you have no choice, but if you go to a single hook, it really cuts back on the foul hook fish, and you're gonna land a lot more fish on these laser minnows with a single hook, that's for sure. And this color right here is definitely the hot color.
Welcome back to the Sacramento River. I'm Justin Wolf. Guide Raith Heryford's looking for finicky winter run king salmon with the recipients of the Wear It California campaign fishing tutorial with Angler West TV. It's a chilly day, so it's a good thing Bass Pro Shops provided jackets.
Everyone was complaining how cold that boat ride is, but this Bass Pro Shop Gore-Tex Pro Qualifier jacket, can't feel a thing. Comfy, cozy, warm.
Throughout the morning, Raith searched for fish in several holes and used several techniques, including boondogging row, using the spinning tackle also provided by Bass Pro Shops. But in the end, it was the P-Line laser minnow that made the day a success.
Fish on!
Nice.
Come to daddy.
Okay guys, what's going on? They just hooked a big fish. And it's a big silver bullet, and man, that thing took off. It came up to the top. It's got that single hook in it. Hopefully it'll stick. Most of the time they do, but it's a nice big fish. He's gonna try to go under the bottom of the boat. But
all right, come on. Oh yeah.
Big fish.
Come here, daddy. Oh, look at that. Don't fork it, Mike.
He's really shaking. He's in the top part of the mouth. Okay, reel down. You gotta put some pressure on him.
Don't let no slack in that line.
There we go. Walk right up to the edge. There you go. All the way down. You only want to get about 6 inches of line at a time now. There you go, lift him. He's gonna come right around over here. Lift him. He's stalling. There you go. Reel all the way down now. Reel all the way to water. Okay, now lift nice and slow. Now reel all the way down. There you go, perfect. Nice and all the way down. Here we go. Lift. Lift, pull, buddy, pull.
That was awesome. That was unreal. That's got to be one of my biggest fish. Being a bass fisherman, this is a whole different world. And man, between Wear It California and RH Guides and you guys over there at Angler TV, this has been a great day.
We worked hard for that fish all day long. We've been, you know, winter run salmon, you never know. You got to work, try everything. We've used row, we used flatfish, we used jigs.
You get a handle on him.
But if you go all day long, you'll end up with a fish like that.
Yeah, that's right. I'm gonna be eating tonight. Well, we've had a fantastic day out here fishing, and it was all brought to us by Wear It California. We were at a tournament, and we took a pledge to always wear our life jackets because of the safety, and you know, you never know what's gonna happen. So we got signed up, and my name got pulled, and we were able to come out here and do some salmon fishing. We got a nice salmon in the tank, and we're looking to get a couple more. It was all brought to us by Werrett, California, R&H Guide Services, and Angler West TV is out here, and it's been a fantastic day. Weather's held out for us, and we've been having a great time, and I want to thank everyone at Werrett, California. I suggest to everyone, if you're in a boat, wear it, California, because it could save your life.
Up next, Don Newman is taking the P-Line Laser Minnow to Lake Berryessa, where he'll join Todd Storm for a day of red-hot trout fishing with guide Rick Kennedy.
The cows are feeding, the fish are biting, so we got some cows over there, so it should be pretty good today.
We've launched out of Markley Cove on Lake Berryessa with guide Rick Kennedy, who's fishing with Todd Storm and Don Newman of P-Line. Berryessa has developed into one of California's top fisheries, partly due to a pen rearing program established back in 1999.
Right over there is some pens that Californian Fisheries Foundation puts in and maintains every year. They plant raised trout there and release them here every year, and that definitely has a lot to do with the trophy trout that we're catching this lake. It's a great, great opportunity and puts a lot of fish in the water.
Berryessa is loaded with trout, and this time of year, most of them are feeding on shad near the surface. So if you can find the bait fish, you're likely to find some great fishing.
Okay, we're heading up into what they call Rag Canyon. We're going along here looking up into all these little fingers to see if there's birds working. And as soon as I spot some birds, we're going to go back up into one of these little creeks and inlets and start throwing some spoons and see if we can't get some fish.
Oh, it's wet.
Putting that dot on to try and simulate a small threat in shad?
That's my secret weapon.
It's not so secret anymore.
What color you got? Oh, you got the pearl one? Okay, let's try that one for a little while. And if you don't get something pretty quick, we're going to switch over to the pink. The pink was the hot one yesterday in here.
Got it on the front here. Check it out. Today we're going to be using 1/2 and 3-ounce quarter laser minnows, and basically there's a lot of shad schooled up in the back of these coves, so the trout have kind of got them balled up, and we're going to find the bait balls and see if there's some fish holding.
Well, we're going to move up here in the head of this little cove here where those birds are working. It's going to get a little shallower, so you're going to have to just retrieve a little faster, but there's a bunch of fish up in there, a lot of bait.
Got some redfin shad here, so hopefully it'll make them bite, eat it. So we'll just put a little bit on there on both sides of the spoon.
There's one.
Take your time, Don. Let me get the net.
Okay.
Right at the end, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems like when you try to first take them up, they, nice. Nice little rainbow.
That's a 12, 13 inch rainbow. Clean fish, look how bright they are.
This is actually a little smaller than the ones we were catching yesterday. That's always the case, right?
I'm gonna switch colors right now. I'm gonna go to the laser minnow 1/2 ounce pink. Seems to be working, getting a little more bites on that. I was using the shad color, but we'll get a little more flash and a little more color in the pink here.
Rick, that one hit it as soon as that spoon hit the water. It hadn't fallen more than a foot when he hit it.
Fish jumping, boiling everywhere. Nice little trout.
That's a nicer fish. Fatter anyway, it looks like.
Yeah. Boy, they're just hammering the spoon.
Aren't they? They love them things.
God. So I just put a little perk here on a little while ago, so I'll just put a little more on. About every, 15, 20 minutes probably.
get that scent trail going, because we're fishing pretty fast, so you want a little scent trail right on top so they can follow it and find the spoon and bite it.
So for this type of fishing on a spinning reel, we're using 6 pound CX Premium. Main reason is the castability. We can make real long casts. We're seeing fish kind of blowing up all over this cove, and we can cast to where the boils are at. In other situations, we've got some reels with the halo, and the halo is 100% fluorocarbon. It's a mist green color, and it sinks a little bit faster when the fish get a little bit more spooky, because the invisibility factor works a little bit better. So we're using two different lines out here today.
So I threw that little red UV crip lure on there and threw it out there against the bank and kind of let it just fall off with the ledge there, kind of try to work it down, and hooked up right away. Don, you want to take this?
No.
Here, take it.
I don't need a handout just yet.
Here.
Nope, absolutely not.
Todd, you want it?
You guys got to have a little problem.
I want to see how a pro fights a trout.
I'll probably lose it.
Come on, let's see how you do it. Oh,
it's a stinking bass.
It's a bass.
I don't believe it.
Look, a nice spot though.
A crip lure, a bass on a crip lure. Wait till I get a hold of Morales.
Right?
Maybe I ought to start entering some tournaments.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to come up.
Spotted bass. Watch it, has teeth.
Never thought I'd see the day that I caught a bass.
Welcome back to Lake Berryessa. I'm Justin Wolf. It's the middle of November, the lake has turned over, and we're getting fish on just about every cast.
Man, they're so predictable. They get up and they start chasing the bait, and you throw anything near them and they'll eat it.
Need the net, Don?
I don't know.
It's better without it.
Oh, he's gone.
Perfect.
Nope, don't need the net, Rick.
Yeah.
Most of the time, finding feeding birds means feeding fish. But none of this can happen without a healthy bait fish population.
Yeah, I've been fishing Berryessa for quite a few years, and we really lost a lot of shad population here on this lake for some reason, probably because of low water, but we've had quite a few years of high water, and we've had some really good shad spawns. So the shad are small right now, but we have a lot of shad in the system right now. So these fish are really benefiting from that, and we are too. So it's great. It's a great combination. Yeah, I like the new spot.
I'm going to drop it a little deeper and try and vertical jig it and see what happens.
Hey, we just had another one back here. They're literally almost every cast, huh?
Yeah. Oh, there he goes. He ate it right there.
That was awesome.
You got him gone?
God, he would come up and spin on it. Look at it, 3-4 times.
Well, we got a double going. Good job, guys. No pink laser minnow.
Oh, man. Nothing better.
You got him?
Yep, there we go.
Perfect. Good job.
We're getting them every cast now.
It's a terrible thing, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
One of the things that happens during the fall is when the water temperature starts to change, you've got the lake that turns over. And basically what happens is you've got a thermocline, and the water basically on the bottom, once that temperature switches and you've got cooler water on the surface and warmer water down below, the fish get active, the bait gets up on the surface, the fish chase them quite a bit, and that's why they've really gotten active right now.
Oh, big trout.
Good. Good deal.
All right, double header.
Big trout.
Oh, that's a nice fish.
Yeah.
Beautiful fish.
Come on. Get in here. That's what we're looking for.
Yeah.
That's a trout.
Now we're talking. Want to take him home for dinner? Look at that. Nice fish. Yeah, this is kind of a nice change for me, because I spend 99% of my time trolling all these lakes for trout and salmon and what have you. And This is a treat when you can come out here and do something different.
It's about 11 o'clock right now, and I'm really ripping the spoon to get a reaction bite. They're really coming after it. Rip it up about 3 or 4 feet. They see it, they come and react on it. And so it's a really nice reaction bite right now. It's like every cat right now. There's a nice clean one.
Nice clean fish, huh?
Thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.